Hi, friends. Good evening. My name is Nikki, and I'm thrilled to have you all here. We'll be watching my Capstone project, which incorporates my passion for singing, movie making, and acting, and spoken word poetry. I self-directed, performed, and created one unified artistic project that is informed by psychology, social theory, where I showcase a singing performance, but also tell a deep and meaningful cinematic documentary style story to manifest my overlapping identities, or rather my transformative perspective of authentic identity. So I present to you, I Am Fusion, the title of my project, and in the chat box, you can see the link to the YouTube video if the Zoom presents any tech difficulties. And at the end of the presentation, I welcome any questions you may have that you can leave in the chat box or ask me after the presentation if you prefer, and I'll be emailing you guys after. So you can begin.
Days are going by, and I'm thinking of this concept of a capstone passion project. This self-exploratory project captures emotional honesty, longing, vulnerability. I hope this also reflects the beauty and solace of the coexistence of melancholy and beauty and ambiguity, as well as feelings of acceptance, peace, and self-awareness. I would like to draw the audience into a captivating performance with compassionate curiosity and have you with me on the journey of soul-felt expression. I found myself in a search for authenticity within all this, where performing arts and poetry became an outlet. And I don't just mean the words thoughtfully created order or about hitting those notes in the song, but also the emotional journey. And music, dance, and theater make you feel understood and alive, and take you to a place where you feel safe, even just momentarily. So in the early stages of my research, the song Creep captured my attention, particularly its paradox. Let's have a listen. Study and looking into the song, it reminded me of the personality typing model called Enneagrams. This song indirectly showcased an aspect of the type 4 Enneagram which I'd been studying, since it resonated with me as my dominant typing. Type 4s are known as the individualists or the romantics of the Enneagram. They're known to be self-aware, artistically inclined, and introspective. The sensitive 4s are drawn to authenticity, intensity, and emotional depth. They also express this kind of inconsolable longing for an unnameable missing piece that they're trying to find and recover so that they feel like they can be part of the world. They believe the only way to recapture their missing piece and finally secure an authentic identity is by cultivating a unique image. The character in this song longs for and desires a sense of belonging, to be special and matter, to feel like they're not creeping on this perfect world like an outsider, and ultimately have a positive impact on those around them. As I went deeper into analyzing the song's lyrics, I realized that the contradicting nature of the song starts off with how on the surface it's about feeling out of place, feeling different, like an alien, a weirdo. But at the same time, someone whose longing launches them on a lifelong quest towards self-discovery and serving the world. So, I'm of the opinion that this song is not really about being insecure or feeling insignificant. It's about recognizing who you are and coming to a greater self-knowledge and understanding of your inherent worth and your humanity. Its message is not about resorting and sulking in this alienation and longing, but allowing it to be catalysts for some fruitful and powerful authenticity and meaning and identity.
I don't care if it hurts. I wanna have control. I want a perfect body. I want a perfect soul. I want to be noticed for who I am inside. You're so very special. I wish I was special.
Deep into the profound awareness of the world around me and to redirect my energy from just feeling these emotions to acting, I found myself on a path to search for a true authentic identity. Shortly after, I started to doubt about whether such an authenticity exists, as my search constantly led me to dead ends. I was overwhelmed with the sense of not quite fitting into the molds and meaningfully belonging. I've become aware of the fact that my cross national, racial, ethnic, religious, and linguistic linkages strongly contest the conventional expressions of one true identity and belonging. Inspired by multiculturalism, I've also been held to believe that my identity entails distinct, independent micro-identity mosaics that have been carefully placed side by side to create a bigger picture of who I am. The truth is, I need to rethink these constructions. So, who was I? As I sailed through the waters of uncertainties, Audrey Fleurs' book became a lighthouse in my unsettled ocean of selfhood. I came to realize that we are more than diverse mosaics of unchangeable molded identity groups. Our identity is like a kaleidoscope that constitutes hybridized fusions of many overlapping and intersecting identities. I realized that looking for authenticity then would be misleading because of the dynamic essence of fusion of identities. When we can move beyond the mosaic identity politics that just conflate distinctiveness, we can look forward to explore this notion of identity that is a novel entity derived from all the fissures, fissions, and fusions as I experienced and lived in the world of diversity. So we're unique and special because we are a product of the fusion of identities. Why? Because in a fusion, our identities are always in the state of being and becoming and evolving. And that's a healing truth.
But I'm a creep. Ooh. I said it. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? Oh, I don't
And that's a wrap.
Hi guys.
I hope that
was amazing.